Take a look at how to make the most of Preethi Nitro. Fixing the blade. Fixing the blade in the jar is easy. Just hold the coupler at the bottom of the jar tightly with your fingers and turn the jar straight. Place the blade onto the spindle now. To tighten the blade, use the spanner on the stirrer and turn it anti-clockwise. Please ensure that you use the correct blade for the required operation. For instance, use the multi-purpose grinding blade for wet and dry grinding. Use the mincer blade for grating, mincing and crushing. And use the whipper blade for whipping, blending, churning and liquidizing. Seating the jar. This is the top cap and seat the jar assembly on it like this. Be sure that the jar base locks into the grooves of the top cap. This can be done by turning the jar clockwise. Do not operate the mixer grinder unless the jar is properly locked onto the base. Dome seating. Place the dome on the jar and press tightly till the rubber beading seats inside the jar. This will ensure proper seating of the dome on the jar and prevent leaking. Wet grinding. When you're making idli, dosa, utappam, appam, pesirattu or vada, Preethi helps you to do it with ease. Use the 1.7 liters jar fixed with a multi-purpose blade. Soak rice and dal separately for 7 to 8 hours and drain the water from the ingredients. You can grind a maximum of 350 grams of soaked rice, which is slightly less than half the jar. Add one tumbler, that's about 200 ml of water first, and pulse for 3 to 4 times. Then, run on speed 3 for about 60 seconds till it forms a thick paste. For 350 grams of soaked rice, use 150 grams of soaked dal, which will be at the blade level. Add half a tumbler, that's about 100 ml of water, and pulse for 3 to 4 times. Then run on speed 3 for about 15 seconds. Stop and stir and grind for about 15 seconds till the dal mixture becomes a fine paste. To make vada, grind similarly. You can grind a maximum of 350 grams of soaked rice or 250 grams of soaked dal. Do not exceed the specified quantities. To grind more quantity, grind twice. The quantity of water and grinding time will vary depending on the quality of rice or dal and soaking time. Add enough water to ensure free circulation. Dry grinding. You can dry grind roasted cereals, dry masala, dal, roasted coffee, coriander seeds, red chilies, pepper and raw rice into fine powder. For dry grinding small quantities, use the chutney grinder, and for larger quantities, use the main or the middle jar. The ingredients, jar and blade should be thoroughly dried before use. Put the ingredients into the jar and pulse 5 to 10 times and then run in speed 3 for 30 seconds. If you want the powder to be finely ground, grind in speed 3 for another 30 seconds. Pulse. The pulse function is ideal for chutney grinding, dry grinding, meat mincing, vegetable grating and ice crushing. Preethi mixer grinder comes with a rotary switch which is equipped with a pulse facility. To pulse, simply turn the rotary switch anti-clockwise and release. Repeat the operation several times until the material is grated or crushed. Grating and mincing. Meat mincing, vegetable grating or ice crushing can be smoothly done in the 1.7 liters jar with a grater or mincer blade. Before grating or mincing, ensure that the blade is fixed in the jar. During mincing, ensure that the bone and fat are completely removed from the meat. During grating, cut the vegetable into 1-inch cubes and fill the jar to the blade level only. Pulse 10 to 15 times or till the material is minced or grated. Repeat if the quantity is more. Flexi lid. Preethi's continuous innovation has resulted in various unique features like the flexi lid. This helps in converting its 1.7 liters jar to 1.2 liters jar. This makes the work easy for lesser quantity grinding without changing the jar. Auto Overload Protector. Preethi Mixer Grinder has Auto Overload Protector which stops the mixer grinder from running if the motor is overloaded. If your mixer grinder stops running, switch it off and remove some material from the jar to decrease the load. Wait for 3 minutes, then lift the body and press the red button seen in the bottom part to restart the mixer grinder. Grind and store. To make coconut chutney, put the ingredients into the container. Invert the jar and turn clockwise till it is properly locked. Pulse for 3 to 4 times and add little water. Then run on speed 1 only till the grinding is complete. After grinding, remove the assembly from the top cap. Invert the assembly and hold the container on one hand. Twist and open anti-clockwise to release the container. Allow the contents to cool and close container with the cap by turning it clockwise. While dry grinding using the grind and store, never grind for more than 1 minute continuously, as the contents will get excessively hot and can cause the jar to twist out of shape. The airtight containers keep the contents fresh. You can conveniently refrigerate them or use them as serving bowls. Extra jars are also available at a nominal cost. The chutney jar can be used to grind coconut chutney, tomato, mint, onion, or even masala for small quantity gravies. After grinding, to remove the lid, just hold the handle for leverage and push up the dome like this. To remove the jar from the body and lift it off the top cap. Do not remove the jar if the mixer grinder is still running. This will lead to damage of the coupler. Never leave the jar on the mixer grinder when not in use. Cleaning instruction. Clean the body and the top cap with a damp cloth and wipe dry. For the stainless steel jars and blade, first fill in 1/2 liter of lukewarm water and add mild detergent. Run on speed 1 for 30 seconds, then rinse and dry the jar. Always keep the jar in an inverted position to allow the water to drain.